I am the resurrection and the life, saith the Lord. He that believeth in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live. And whosoever liveth and believeth in me shall never die. We brought nothing into this world, and it is certain we can carry nothing out. The Lord gave, and the Lord hath taken away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Itifano, whereas by the death of our late beloved sovereign, Queen Elizabeth II, the crown has solely and rightfully come to His Royal Highness, Prince Charles Philip Arthur George. We therefore, the Right Honourable Dame Cindy Kiro, Governor General of New Zealand, the Right Honourable Jacinda Ardern, Prime Minister of New Zealand, and members of the Executive Council, assisted by members of Parliament, judges and representatives of the realm, and numerous other representative citizens here present, hereby proclaim that His Royal Highness Prince Charles Philip Arthur George is now King Charles III, by the grace of God, King of New Zealand and his other realms and territories, head of the Commonwealth, defender of the faith, to whom his subjects swear their faith and true allegiance with hearty affection, wishing His Majesty King Charles III a long and happy reign. Given under the hand of Her Excellency the Governor General, and issued under the seal of New Zealand this 11th day of September 2022, Jacinda Ardern, Prime Minister. God save the King! Dearly beloved, the Scripture moveth us in sundry places to acknowledge and confess our manifold sins and wickedness, and that we should not dissemble nor cloak them before the face of Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, but confess them with an humble, lowly, penitent, and obedient heart, to the end that we may obtain forgiveness of the same by His infinite goodness and mercy. And although we ought at all times humbly to acknowledge our sins before God, yet ought we chiefly so to do when we assemble and meet together to render thanks for the great benefits that we have received at His hands, to set forth His most worthy praise, to hear His most holy word, and to ask those things which are requisite and necessary as well for the body as the soul. Wherefore I pray and beseech you, as many as are here present, to accompany me with a pure heart and humble voice unto the throne of the heavenly grace, saying after me. Almighty and most merciful Father, we have erred and strayed from thy ways like lost sheep. We have followed too much the devices and desires of our own hearts. We have offended against thy holy laws. We have left undone those things which we ought to have done, and we have done those things which we ought not to have done, and there is no health in us. But thou, O Lord, have mercy upon us, miserable offenders. Spare thou them, O God, which confess their faults. Restore thou them that are penitent, according to thy promises declared unto mankind in Christ Jesus our Lord. And grant, O most merciful Father, for his sake, that we may hereafter live a godly, righteous, and sober life, to the glory of thy holy name. Amen. Almighty God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who desireth not the death of a sinner, but rather that he may turn from his wickedness and live, and hath given power and commandment to his ministers, to declare and pronounce to his people, being penitent, the absolution and remission of their sins. He pardoneth and absolveth all them that truly repent and unfeignedly believe his holy gospel. Wherefore let us beseech him to grant us true repentance and his Holy Spirit, that those things may please him which we do at this present, and that the rest of our life hereafter may be pure and holy, so that at the last we may come to his eternal joy. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Does not wisdom call, and does not understanding raise her voice? On the heights, beside the way, at the crossroads she takes her stand, beside the gates in front of the town, at the entrance of the portals she cries out, to you, O people, I call, and my cry is to all that live. O simple ones, learn prudence, acquire intelligence those who lack it. Hear, for I will speak noble things, and from my lips will come what is right, from my mouth will utter truth. Wickedness is an abomination to my lips. All the words of my mouth are righteous. There is nothing twisted or crooked in them. They are all straight to one who understands and right to those who find knowledge. Take my instruction instead of silver, and knowledge rather than choice gold. For wisdom is better than jewels, and all that you may desire cannot compare with her. I, wisdom, live with prudence, and I attain knowledge and discretion. The fear of the Lord is hatred of evil, and perverted speech I hate. I have good advice and sound wisdom. I have insight, I have strength. By me kings reign, and rulers decree what is just. By me rulers rule, and nobles all who govern rightly. I love those who love me, and those who seek me diligently find me.
Thank you. I saw no temple in the city, for its temple is the Lord God, the Almighty, and the Lamb. And the city has no need of sun or moon to shine on it, for the glory of God is its light, and its lamp is the Lamb. The nations will walk by its light, and the kings of the earth will bring their glory into it. Its gates will never be shut by day, and there will be no night there. People will bring into it the glory and the honor of the nations, but nothing unclean will enter it, nor anyone who practices abomination or falsehood, but only those who are written in the Lamb's Book of Life. Then the angel showed me the river of the water of life, bright as crystal, flowing from the throne of God and of the Lamb through the middle of the street of the city. On either side of the river is the tree of life, with its 12 kinds of fruit, producing its fruit each month. And the leaves of the tree are for the healing of the nations. Nothing accursed will be found there anymore, but the throne of God and of the Lamb will be in it, and his servants will worship him. They will see his face, and his name will be on their foreheads.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sitteth on the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Ki te ingoa te mātua te tāma te wairua tāpu, āmine. How can we begin to sum up a life such as that of Her Late Majesty the Queen? It will be a question that we will slowly answer over the coming days and weeks as our formal tributes and our state funerals and our memorial services are held first in London and then all around the world as we mourn the passing of a sovereign who has provided such leadership to our church, to our nation, to our Commonwealth, that we feel rightly bereft without it. But this night is not the night even to begin to declare all of the great accomplishments and the incredible qualities of Her Late Majesty. That will be for the day when we gather together again to say our formal farewell. This night, we have come to give thanks for a life well lived. We have come in our own grief to gather around our Poheringawaka, our safe mooring post, Christ our Lord, just as Her Majesty did for all the long years of her reign, knowing that to be a monarch, an empress, to be someone who carries such power and authority is both a huge responsibility and a dangerous task. We are all too aware of the dangers and the temptations of unbridled power and influence. And so, with Her Majesty, we look to the only one to whom belongs all our fealty and all our loyalty, to the Lord our God, just as she did. And the texts that we have heard, spoken and sung this evening are the ones which also informed her life and her death. From the book of Proverbs, we heard how important it is to seek wisdom, the most precious thing we can possibly acquire, greater than jewels and gold. Compared to it, every gift that we have is nothing, including the incredible royal jewels that Her Majesty was expected to carry around or to bear the heavy weight of during her reign. The orb which she carried also the cross of Christ to remind her of the kingdom of God. And in its presence she sought that wisdom which would allow her to speak to nations, to peoples, to individuals, with the wisdom of God rather than with the power of a tyrant. Whether it was the knowledge of natural history or of world politics or of motor mechanics or of racing form, Her Majesty sought wisdom wherever she could find it. The precious knowledge which she gathered up all through her life, wherever it was to be found, knowing that in finding wisdom, we find something of the true gifts of God with which a just ruler may reign. And throughout that reign, she also had her eyes fixed, not on earthly things, but on that vision of reconciliation, of peace, of justice, which we are given as the end of all things, God's dream for the whole world, given in the vision of the revelation to St. John. Her Majesty had her eyes fixed on the heavenly Jerusalem. And as she lived a long life of service, of courage through good times and bad, she was heading all of that time towards that heavenly Jerusalem. Eyes fixed and thirsting for the river of the water of life, bright as crystal, which flows from the throne of God and of the Lamb, which brings with it forgiveness, which brings with it the peace which we can only know when our earthly quarrels, when our divisions, when our sad lusts for power and for dominance are put aside, when we lay down all of those things which burden us and cross that river to find the one who can bring us true peace. As Her Late Majesty continued through her final years, lamenting the separation between her and those whom she had loved and who had gone before her, she too knew that our Lord Jesus Christ would one day call her home, a life of service fulfilled. And it is to that home which we now commend her, as we look towards the day when Christ will reconcile all things, when we too will be called to drink of that river of the water of life, when we too will see the heavenly Jerusalem. And on that day, we know and we hope and we pray with Her Late Majesty that God will wipe away all our tears, and there will be no more death, nor sorrow, nor crying, but life everlasting, for which thanks be to God through our Lord Jesus Christ, in the power of the Holy Spirit, today and forever. Amen.
Yeah.
Let us pray. O Lord, our heavenly Father, almighty and everlasting God, by whom kings reign and princes decree justice, we remember before thee our late sovereign lady, Queen Elizabeth, in thankfulness for the blessings which thou hast bestowed upon us by her reign, for the example she set of unwearied devotion to duty, for her steadfast courage, and for the love and loyalty borne to her by a great family of peoples in all parts of the world. And we beseech thee to give us grace that, having these mercies in remembrance, we may with one heart and one mind set forward the welfare of this land and hasten the coming of thy kingdom of peace and goodwill among all thy peoples. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. O Lord God, when thou givest to thy servant to endeavour any great matter, grant us also to know that it is not the beginning, but the continuing of the same to the end, until it be thoroughly finished, which yieldeth the true glory. Through him, for the finishing of thy work, laid down his life. Our Redeemer, Jesus Christ. Amen. O Lord, our heavenly Father, high and mighty, King of kings, Lord of lords, the only ruler of princes, who dost from thy throne behold all the dwellers upon earth. Most heartily we beseech thee with thy favour to behold our most gracious sovereign Lord, King Charles, and so replenish him with the grace of thy Holy Spirit, that he may always incline to thy will and walk in thy way. Endue him plenteously with heavenly gifts. Grant him in health and wealth long to live. Strengthen him that he may vanquish and overcome all his enemies. And finally, after this life, he may attain everlasting joy and felicity. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, the fountain of all goodness, we humbly beseech thee to bless Camilla, the Queen Consort, William, Prince of Wales, Catherine, Princess of Wales, and all the royal family. Endue them with thy Holy Spirit. Enrich them with thy heavenly grace. Prosper them with all happiness, and bring them to thine everlasting kingdom. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty and everlasting God, who alone workest great marvels, send down upon our bishops and curates and all congregations committed to their charge the healthful spirit of thy grace, and that they may truly praise thee, pour upon them the continual dew of thy blessing. Grant this, O Lord, for the honour of our advocate and mediator, Jesus Christ. Amen. Almighty God, who hast given us grace at this time, with one accord to make our common supplications unto thee, and dost promise that when two or three are gathered together in thy name, thou wilt grant their requests. Fulfill now, O Lord, the desires and petitions of thy servants, as may be most expedient for them, granting us in this world knowledge of thy truth, and in the world to come, life everlasting. Amen. After this evening's service, I shall invite the mayor to come with me and to sign the book of condolence, after which you are welcome also to leave messages for His Majesty the King of condolence on the passing of Her late Majesty the Queen. Would you please be upstanding if you are able for the blessing? God grant to the living grace, to the departed rest, to the church, the king, the commonwealth, and all humankind peace and concord, and to us and to all God's servants life everlasting, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost be among you and remain with you always. Amen.
Let us bless the Lord.